My name is Megan McCord. I'm a marine ecologist here at Gulf Islands National Park Reserve on the traditional unceded territory of the Coast Salish Nations.
My name is Bronwyn. I'm a marine management officer. Right here, I'm putting up our marine research flag that lets other boaters know that we are allowed to research the southern resident killer whales.
The first thing we're going to do is head out to Saturna Island Interim Sanctuary Zone, and it's here that we're hoping we might have our first sighting of southern resident killer whales.
Batteries on. Now we're going to make sure that our boat is actually working today. That's a good noise. I'm just leaving the harbor.
Right, and boy, we'll be there.
Right now at the entrance to Active Pass, a component of our transect survey where we stop, look and listen for southern resident killer whales. While we're doing our surveys, we're also deploying these acoustic hydrophones to monitor the amount of noise that we're hearing in the ocean environment. What you can hear now is the sound of a small vessel with some really loud engines and propellers. This noise actually prevents them from communicating with each other while they're socializing or hunting. So we hope by recording some of the vessel traffic and really better understanding the types of noise that we have here in the Southern Salish Sea, that we'll be able to identify potential areas as no-go zones. So areas where boats are not allowed, where whales can hunt and socialize as we know they love to do.
Some visual surveys of pinnipeds like harbor seal and sea lion. And these photographs are going to be shared with our partners such as Fisheries and Oceans Canada as part of a multi-agency approach to monitor species within the southern resident killer whale habitat.
Trying to find a good location here at the Java Islets where Winnie can hop off and see if she can find some harbor seal poo. One of the most important things to remember when you're working with pinniped or seal or sea lion poop is that it's really smelly. So bringing your trusty gloves along is really important.
So we're here on the Java Islets and I am on the hunt for scat. One of the more glamorous sides of biology is we often will look for fecal residue from various animals that we are studying in order to get a better understanding of their diet, the population dynamics, and it just gives us a better sense of how pinnipeds are interacting with their environment, what their populations look like, and what they're eating, which is very important as they are a large part of the food web within the southern resident killer whale habitat. All right, so sometimes science doesn't always work out. We've done our initial survey and I can't seem to find anything that is really going to be useful for testing for the variables that I mentioned earlier. So I think it's time to get back on the boat.
We are about to deploy our baited remote underwater video system, which is comprised of two cameras and this really wonderful canister, really, that we're going to fill with our kilogram of herring. What we're hoping to do here is to deploy the BREV and monitor the types of fish that are using the kelp forests of the protected waters in the park reserve. So our study here today is really aimed at understanding this complex environment that the southern resident killer whales call home, and hoping to document the species that occur here and create this long-lasting archive of the incredible fish that call the Pacific Northwest and the waters of Parks Canada and Gulf Islands National Park Reserve home.